What's up, guys? It's Miss Johnson, and today we're going to be learning about the er sound. There are four spellings that make the er sound. It's er, ir, ur, or. All four of those spellings make the er sound. Now, I have to be honest and let you guys know that there isn't a rule that tells you when to use which spelling. You really just have to memorize the spelling of certain words. But what I do want you to learn today is that when you hear the er sound in a word, it is either er, ir, ur, or. I've put this card here today to help us remember what sound all of those spellings make. They all make the er sound, as in shirt, as in shirt. So whenever you forget, you can always go back and remember the word shirt and remember that the er sound in that word is the sound that those spellings make. Let's practice. What sound does IR make? Very good. What about ER? UR? And OR? Very good. I want you guys to notice that there are two letters here, but they only make one sound. And so remember that when you see these letters together in a word, you never ever separate the sounds. You always make that one sound of er. Let's practice some more. If I wrote a word that had a W, O, R, and an M, I would create a word. Now we need to sound out this word. So everybody put your elbow up and let's tap this word out to see what word these letters make. Ready? Worm. Worm. Very good. The next one, everybody put your elbow up and let's tap this out. Ready? Shirt. Shirt. I hope you guys remember that SH is a digraph. And when we see SH, we make one sound and it is sh. So this word is shirt. Shirt. The next word, you guys put your elbow up and you guys tap this out on your own and then we'll do it together. Let's see, ready? Her. Very good. I know somebody got that right. The next one, elbow up. You tap it out first and then we'll do it together. Ready? Fur. Very good. Let's keep practicing. Now this time you're going to spell some words. Your job right now is to look at the picture, say the name of the picture out loud, and then spell the name of the picture on this line. To help you, I gave you a letter bank. So you can only use the letters in this letter bank to help you spell these words. And don't forget about our card over here that helps us remember what sound each of our spellings make. Let's do the first one together. The word is worm. So now you should put your elbow up and you should tap out the word worm. Ready? W-erm. How would you spell it? I hope you started with a W. And I know it's tricky to know which spelling, but in worm we use O-R. And then I hope you guys put an M for the M sound at the end. So you spell worm, W-O-R-M. Good job, guys. Now what I want you to do is go get a piece of paper and a pencil so you can do numbers 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 by yourself. Please go get a piece of paper and a pencil. And if you need more time, go ahead and pause this. And when you're done working, come unpause me so that we can go over your work together to see if you got the right answers. You may pause the video now. Great job, guys, working through this. I know it's really, really difficult to figure out which spelling you use for the sound er, but we're gonna go through it right now together. All right, So number two is a bird. What's the word? Very good. Put your elbow up and let's tap out that word bird. Ready? B-erd. Good. So I hope you wrote B-I-R-D, bird. Number three is shirt, shirt. Everybody put your elbow up and let's tap this out. Ready? Shirt, shirt. I know you guys wrote that. Number four, the word is surf. Ready? Surf. Put your elbow up and let's tap out surf. Ready? Surf. Surf. Good job. I hope you guys spelled it like this. Again, I know choosing which spelling is the hardest part, but as long as you guys picked one of the four spellings on this card, I'll be happy with that. Let's do number five. It says, write two sentences, use one or two words from the box in each sentence. So this word would be her. This word would be nurse. This word would be girl. And this word would be work. You could have tapped all of these words out with your elbow up. Now you won't have the same sentence as me, but as long as you used one of the words from the box, that's all I ask for. So here's my first sentence. The girl will be a nurse. Did anybody have this sentence? It's okay if you didn't. I'm sure your sentence is just as great. Here's my next sentence for number six. Her dog is brown. Did anybody have this sentence? That's okay. You guys come up with great sentences all the time. Now I want to read some of the words in sentences. Are you ready? Here's my first sentence. All you have to do is read it in your brain or whisper it to yourself, and then we'll read it together. Read the sentence. Yeah, so there are three words in here that have our spelling pattern. And so all you need to remember is that the spelling pattern make what sound? Er. Very good. So here is the sentence. Let's see if you got it right. The big bird lurks on top of the church. Perfect. Repeat it after me. Ready? The big bird lurks on top of the church. Good job. And here's the last one. Again, you guys look at the sentence, figure out the words that have our spelling pattern. You read it to yourself and then we'll read it together. Again, this sentence has three words that have our spelling pattern. And remember, no matter what the spelling is, they all say er. So let's see if you read the sentence just like me. Fern will hurry back to change her skirt. Repeat after me, ready? Fern will hurry back to change her skirt. Great job, guys. That's it, you did it, good job. Thank you so much for sticking it out with me. I know this was a little difficult, but the only way you get good at this is to practice, practice, practice. Good job, guys.